In the week of May 23, 2022, the activity at the erupting Bezymianny volcano in Russia slowly began intensifying. As its primary lava dome grew larger and larger, it became increasingly unstable. This resulted in periodic small collapses of the dome, creating an ever-increasing number of pyroclastic flows and ash emissions. Then, on May 28th at around 8:10 a.m. local time, a far more powerful explosion occurred. As a plume of ash shot high into the atmosphere, part of the eruption column collapsed downwards, releasing energetic pyroclastic flows. These pyroclastic flows traveled at least 6 kilometers to the southeast and 5.5 kilometers to the west based on the continuing thermal signatures the superheated deposits gave off as they cooled. The associated cloud of ash rose to a height of 15.2 kilometers or 49,900 feet while drifting to the east-southeast. The vast majority of this eruption was over within 20 minutes as eruptive activity drastically dropped, instead producing far smaller and intermittent explosions. What had just occurred was the largest volcanic eruption Bezymianny had produced since at least 2000, potentially even its largest event since a major explosive eruption in 1956. This sequence was either a large volcanian or small subplanarian eruption. It left behind a discernible layer of ash visible from satellite, which covered an area of several hundred square kilometers. As the ash plume continued drifting to the east, it caused minor flight disruptions for aircraft flying over the western and central Aleutian Islands. For context, the Bezymianny volcano is located in east-central Kamchatka, where it is 350 kilometers north-northeast of Petropavlovsk-Kamchatsky. Within a 15-mile or 24-kilometer radius of its summit are several other famous volcanoes such as Tolbochik with its large volume fissure eruptions, and Klyuchevskoy, which is the tallest active volcano on the peninsula. Bezymianny is the smallest and youngest volcano of this group, as it only began forming 4,700 years ago. Before 1955, Bezymianny was long thought to be an extinct volcano. This is how it received its name, which roughly translates to unnamed, indicating the very low threat local scientists thought the volcano posed. Then, after 1,000 years of dormancy, the volcano awoke on October 22nd of 1955. Over the next several months, a large body of magma intruded into its southeastern flank, destabilizing the entire edifice. Then, on March 30th, 1956, 0.8 cubic kilometers of the volcano dramatically collapsed to the southeast, sending a massive landslide and pyroclastic flows up to 18 kilometers distant. The associated eruption plume subsequently rose to a height of 40 kilometers, representing the peak of this VEI-5 eruption. If this eruption sounds strangely familiar to you, then you are not alone. Its 1955 to 1957 eruptive sequence was near identical, although slightly smaller, than the more famous 1980 eruption of Mount Saint Helens. Both eruptions left behind large horseshoe-shaped collapse scars, after which frequent eruptions were directed in the same direction of the collapse scar. While Mount Saint Helens is not erupting, Bezymianny has been near continuously erupting since 1955. Its latest eruption began on May 21st of 2010, and it's continuing at the present. Most of its eruptive activity during this time span has consisted of volcanian explosions and small lava dome collapse caused pyroclastic flows. These both occurred from its ever-growing lava dome, which has largely filled in a section of the existing collapse scar. Most of these eruptions only send ash plumes to a height of between 2 and 5 kilometers. However, on rarer occasions, eruption columns reach in the 6 to 14 kilometer height range, and on only 5 occasions since 2000, a 15 kilometer high eruption plume has been generated. This seemingly represents the maximum height this volcano can produce given the nature of its current eruptive activity. In the next several days to weeks, the eruption of Bezymianny will likely continue, but at a greatly decreased rate. Although no one lives adjacent to this volcano, I would recommend staying at least 15 kilometers away from its summit to the southeast and 10 kilometers away from the rest of the volcano due to the risk of more substantial pyroclastic flows. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. I also wish to give a special thanks to Bevin Boulder for supporting this channel.